With this powder, we can make these pills. It can be a paracetamol when you are suffering from a headache, or a novel cancer treatment, or any other pill. But how does that work? Well, the powder flows through a production line and is at the end compressed into pills. It looks easy, but for this we need a nice and steady flow of powder. And sometimes that can pose some serious challenges. In an ideal scenario, the powder flows through a big production line into a small hole. By a cylinder on top, it is compressed into a pill. Then it gets ejected, the hole is filled again, and the process starts all over. But sometimes the powder does not fill the hole, or it gets stuck somewhere else in the production line. Then the whole line has to be stopped, and that is a huge waste of time and material. So you may wonder, isn't there a way to predict a powder's behavior to avoid these problems? The answer is yes, by using a model. When something is too big or too expensive or too material demanding to test it in a real-life situation, modeling is a good way to scale down reality. In our case, testing all possible powder mixtures inside the production line would cost a lot of material and time. What do we do instead? We take a small amount of powder mix into our lab, do a couple of measurements on it, and plug the results into the computer model. The model then acts like a virtual, simplified representation of the production line. As a result, the model tells us if we risk having any problems when making pills. Based on the results of our model, we can better understand how powder flows through the line. That means that we can tune the powder mixture to make the flow and the pills better. So the next time you have to swallow a pill, think about the long way it has come.